We've got them just in case we want to sit down, but I think they're probably all right. So we're missing, I don't know, a friend of mine. So, just have your feet shoulder width apart and we're just turning the waist. Well, I think one of them's got to take her grand, Nathan's got to go somewhere, so she's having to take him to check the doctor's out, to have the eyes tested. Cheap for this music thing, the Burwell Band. bash. I used to go to the meeting thing. So we're just doing this. That's obvious. I can't believe I didn't think of that myself. Thank you. I'll get in touch with them because that might be even better to do a weekend residential in Burwell. We could have day trippers then.
Yeah.
We could have day trippers.
That's right. You get some of them who have to stay in Burwell.
And it is nice. I mean, there is a lovely garden.
Ask for the venue first. Ask for the venue first. Mm. And then say, I'm just going to want you to stay in that really. And then people can make their own mind.
The people can make their own mind if they want to stay over or not. I mean, I probably would stay there just so I could be on site. But we could do something Friday, Saturday and Sunday. But that is genius. And then we wouldn't need to hardly go anywhere.
Yeah.
We just...
It
is lovely, that place, and the food was delicious. And they did funny diets as well. They were absolutely nonplussed. They were just like, okay, let's just do this. Yeah, everybody. Hello. Hello! Sorry, we had to shut the door because we were freezing.
Yeah, I can understand that. It's just cold. Hi.
Thanks for coming. Oh, this is more like it. I don't feel quite so... I wasn't expecting anybody to come.
That's good.
Yes. I'm very impressed by anybody that makes the effort of coming out to some place like this in this temperature.
Yeah,
so thank you.
All the way across the screen, it's really difficult for me.
I mean, maybe...
Can I spell Burning Marta?
Burning Marta.
What does that mean?
That's a new word. That's a new one.
Joan of Arc.
Yeah.
What?
Joan of Arc!
See, you have the least
to come.
I don't know, I have competition over there, don't
you? No, you don't have the least.
Well, he's got
you don't even have to cross the road.
No. Oh, hello!
Hey!
Hello.
Hello.
Hello! We've got another one.
Are you
That's right. It's all right, we didn't notice you were late at all, it's fine. Yeah. I'm just very thankful that anyone turns up.
Have we got no chairs?
We've got posh chairs out for you.
Yeah, I got those out for you, the posh chairs.
Oh, they are?
Posh chairs.
They're sturdy. They're a bit heavier to lug about, but they're worth it because they're really stable and sturdy. So we're just doing bounce.
They're yours then.
Joan has had to go to the hospital today.
Okay, what, with Nathan or?
Yeah, with the Bradley.
Oh, Bradley, okay, different one.
The younger one.
The younger one, okay.
Yeah.
We'll do the monies at the end. We'll do the monies at the end. So do remember to pay me, those of you that were.
If I put the person on top, so that should be all right.
Actually, that could be really ideal if we just did it in Burwell.
Yeah. No.
No?
Don't go
all
that way.
Oh, I can't go that far. No, you see? Two of us can't go that far.
No. For a residential. Oh,
for a residential retreat. I'm looking for somewhere to do a lovely retreat, a Tai Chi retreat.
Oh, I see. No, I thought you meant on a Wednesday.
No. It'd be on Friday, Saturday and Sunday. And I've been contacting all these different hostels all over the country to see where we can go. But it would have to be somewhere quite close. So we're doing Shake now. But then Nicola said, well, why don't you try that place in Burwell?
Burwell retreat.
Oh, I went there.
I went there for the music thing, and it was lovely. They've got loads of different rooms you can go in. They've got yummy food. They've got a beautiful garden.
Yeah.
So it would be like being in nature, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Just in Burwell.
It's not... I went there for a... What were we looking at? Family history.
I mean, it's bunk beds and that, but it's pretty good. I mean, it's only for a weekend.
But I went home every night.
Yeah.
I've got two to look after.
Some people buy their own house.
Yeah, some people, and the thing is, anyone that lives in Burnwell, they just have the daybreak.
And
I think that's genius. I'll contact them. But I just quite fancy being in a different part of the country in the countryside. But that would be a good time. We could do something in June. We could do something in June at Burwell House.
Put it on the back burner.
I'm gonna. I won't do it for the March and April one. maybe, although they tend to get quite full up, but I can ask them.
Yeah.
A lot of schools used to use it. I don't know what you can do with it. And this was before you could have computers and do things online.
We want to make sure our joints are around on in the night because he'd be looking. He'd be bullying. So he turned the bed
the other way.
He gave him a bash.
Oh gosh.
It was like, it wasn't really his fault.
Yeah.
But I had to be told anyway. And that's when we realised Dad had issues.
And then we go. Well, he's all right.
He's fine,
but
he won't put up with anything.
Good job.
I don't blame him.
He's
got my vote anyway.
I know, I was saying, like, yeah, I get that, yeah. And what did you do about it then? Yeah. When Dan had got to the point where he had to thump somebody, I think.
Well, the school let him down.
Yeah.
Is it drafty in here? We've got the
cold.
It is drafty. I mean, if you want to shut the curtains,
there's a bit of sun.
But then there's sunshine. Although there's no sun coming through there, is there? It's coming in that way. Yeah. I mean, the problem is when the curtains are open, it makes the heat. Waterproof, yeah.
But yeah. I must be the only person who
complained.
And they leaked.
No, I think
they all leak eventually. And then you have to buy that Nikwax re-waterproofing stuff.
You spend
hours doing that, and they still leak. I think it's Gore-Tex. It's only got a service life of about 2 or 3 years, and after that.
No, mine leaked just as they went out of guarantee.
Oh, no.
Wow. So you only got a year?
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah.
And the other side?
Which way is that? Jules.
Thanks for thinking.
Good old fashioned leather walking boots. Australian.
Well, I've asked my teacher, Mark, and he's got two related to a bird.
Must be the most unluckiest person.
And then I'll get all the prizes in the different places and then ask people where do you want to go and have a map.
Yeah.
And say where do you want to go.
Because I thought blinks are cozy and then I wore them.
But yeah, that would be a really easy way. You know, I don't think it's quite bad. I could stay over there or I could go home. Okay, so nice and relaxed, breathing in and out. Oh, just feel the ground under the feet. We're just going to do this one. So. Because in cold weather, it can get all your back and your joints and everything all to seize up. That's not much fun. So we're being very kind. So the theme for today is kindness.
Have you done a happy clappy one?
We did that a few weeks ago, didn't we? Yeah, we did. Heaven's Breath Qigong. Yeah, Heaven's Breath. They love that. I taught it to my intermediates this morning and they were a bit nonplussed by it all. They're a bit like, what are we doing this for?
Okay,
they got a bit snobby about it.
So we're beginners, if they're intermediate.
It's pretty much of a, I mean, the people that have been with me at least 10 years, they learn slightly more complicated stuff. And that's my Burwell class. Burwell, the first class in Burwell. Then there's a beginner's class. And then the Friday morning on Zoom, I do more complicated. Well, not complicated, just more in-depth stuff. I mean, it's all the same stuff, really.
I moved from Burwell because the Burwell class got too big.
Oh,
all right.
Exclusive giving.
It's much better now. It's thinned out a bit because that's what usually happens. You get like with the beginners, there's a lot less, and the intermediates there's, you know. So although sometimes we get 10, it depends who's off and who's around.
Well, that second class, you had about...
Oh, the second class, yeah, that's still quite full, yeah. Yeah, the first class isn't, but then, yeah.
I can't get up that early.
Yeah, a lot of people can't get up that early. Yeah. No, totally understood.
I've got to walk the dogs before I come.
Yeah, exactly.
It's
yeah.
The jobs you've got to do before you can settle down.
And then we go in the other direction, that's good. So we just want to relax the arms. And this is just a very gentle way. This is quite a big version. When we'll look at the small version in a minute, we'll do the big version first. This is more like what I did when I was in Bristol. I spent a day in Bristol training with some people up there. They're really nice bunch, the Bristol lot. Very, very good. Really good. There's another Mark, he's fantastic at Tai Chi, he's really, really good at it. He's been doing it for years. And he goes to China, he went for a few years, he'd go to China every year, he trains with all the masters and grandmasters, he's very, very good, very good. So yeah, Corella and Eva are off to Morocco soon, for 6 weeks.
Six weeks training,
and yeah, I'll go to Burwell. Yeah. No, I'll contact them and see what they've got going around in June. Yeah. That might be a nice one to do.
Yeah.
Just get a nice leave summer.
Right.
Well, yeah.
If
no
one wants it in that week. Mm.
I'll contact them. I'll give them a bell and see what.
Just walk around.
And if people want to come and stay or whatever, you can. So, go. Hang on, we'll do a few more. Well, that's better, isn't it? Okay, come back. And then just do a small one. So with.
Is it the waist or the hips?
You're kind of circling at the top. There is a little bit of waist stuff going on.
But no hips.
Oh, no, they're moving. They're moving because they're all attached, but you're just making the movement smaller. That's it. And then try in the other direction. So we've been, with Eva, I've been looking at big movement and tiny movements. There we go. Nice.
To sit on me.
They were both snug she had loads of clothes on.
That's pretty tip. Do you need cleaning when it's really cold? Just get your hands wet and you'll be
boiling. Oh, that's a good tip. Most of them I've actually fallen back to sleep again while trying to meditate. Oh, yeah. But I've got a very enlightened sleep. No, on the chair.
Oh.
I was just like, and there's this thing called the body scan, because there was a body scan meditation, and you lie down, and then you just scan down the body and get into relax. But then the problem is, every time, out like a light, and then the ding, I get woken up by the ding, and I'm like, oh God, I've done it again. But no, it's been brilliant, and there was, it was 140 to start off with, and now there's about 85. There's still quite a lot of people. But there's the one that's an hour long, 7 till 8, with another lot, Monday to Friday, but
yeah.
Half an hour is better. So,
do you think you would have done it differently if you'd been just on your own? It's the fact that there are lots of other people.
Yeah, if I'd have just done it on my own, I'd have given up long ago. But when you do it with other people and you kind of wave at each other in the morning and then we meditate, it's got quite a, you know, and I don't know, you don't talk to anybody, but you just sit there. It's been really good. I'll definitely do it again. So
when's Tai Chi Day?
Oh, World Tai Chi Day, yeah. I can't remember because I always miss it, but it's really good. Yeah, there's a guy, my friend Keith, he works with a guy in America invented World Tai Chi Day, where everybody does Tai Chi, but I do Tai Chi. I mean, it's World Tai Chi Day every day as far as I'm concerned. So, but I'm really glad it's happening. Yeah, you can do that. I mean, usually somebody, if I get it together, I usually try and do something for World Tai Chi Day. I might do a video and put it up on the YouTube channel for World Tai Chi Day.
And I thought you said Wild Tai Chi.
People in like
Russia. Tai Chi leaping all over the place.
It's like hot yoga.
Wild Tai Chi. I don't think so. I do sedate Tai Chi.
Or wild swimming, what's that?
Oh, that's when you go out and swim and then come back with a horrible illness.
Yeah.
That's wild swimming, isn't it?
Yeah.
Swim in rivers.
And they've got sewage in. And you catch something dodgy. Yeah. My friend loves wild swimming. I go, how can you? And she said, yeah, I've got this really weird skin rash. I'm like,
when the paddlers turned their canoes upside down in the Thames, we feared they'd swallowed water.
Ooh.
As we pulled them out at Westminster, if we had flat Coca-Cola and you pump them with this flat Coca-Cola and they don't get anything,
Because it dissolves everything.
It really did. Flat Coca-Cola is what we used to. Anybody who'd swallowed any Thames water.
Oh, you wouldn't want to drink that.
But that used to be the same amount of can at one time.
Yeah. So relax the shoulders.
It was handy to know that flat Coca-Cola, the compensated dirty water, if somebody swallowed it.
It's probably got, because of all the
nasties
in it, it's probably good for killing all the bugs.
I think it sounds like a whole chunk of cure for COVID.
It does sound a bit like a chunk of cure for COVID.
I think in the old days it used to be bottled as a medicine, didn't it, Cola?
Well,
it
had cocaine in it.
It had cocaine in it.
Yeah,
it was invented as a pick-me-up for invalids.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
So there is some truth in it, I think.
Okay.
Not a lot, but I think there is some truth in it. Yeah.
I went across to Lapland and went to see the place where they had
invented it
and went in a church. It was called the Coca-Cola Church.
So this is silk reading number two, which in 2 days of training with Chen and Jun, Master Chen and Jun, we didn't actually get round to.
Oh.
There you go. Well, you know, they take their time.
Yeah.
Like the two tractors I've got stuck behind. Nothing.
I should have got them to put some Coca-Cola in it then, you know. So try and keep the hands on the same level, look. Numbers, would that help? Yeah, okay. So from here. Perfect. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. So I've got a really nice message too from someone who's just started Tai Chi 3 in Malaysia. Who watches some of my videos, and she liked my casual, hilarious style. because a lot of teachers that do it traditionally are a lot less humorous than me.
I went to a class in Malaysia once.
Yeah.
It was outside in the morning.
Yeah, that's right.
A big park.
That's right.
And it was fine when everyone, you're looking and you can see the teacher, but then everybody turned round and I was like,
the moral of that story is if you're in Malaysia in a Tai Chi class, go in the middle of the group. Then you've always got someone to look at. Yes. Or if you want to go at the end of the group, that's fine, but know what you're doing.
Yeah,
always go in the middle. Safety in numbers, but yeah. So what will happen in Chen in June seminar? Everyone tried to go into the middle. It's really funny. There we go. So yeah, you want to sink the hips. There we go. And we're connecting through the body. So the bounce and shake really help you connect through the body, you see. That's a very good effort. Even those of you that are doing the variation, it still looks quite relaxed. So don't worry, you've fooled me completely. Okay, now we go the other direction. So we start here. One. Two. Three. Four. One. And don't worry, if the tumbleweed's going across your brain, that's fine. Three. Four. This looks simple, but because of life habits and body mechanics, it can be harder than what you want. It's fine. I was teaching on the grass at my friend's mansion last Friday, and my shoes were green, so people couldn't see my feet, so I apologised. Well, sorry about the green shoes. Now a girl can see what I'm doing, but she thought that was hilarious. So I'm very happy for people from all over different countries, you know, to watch my videos, but, you know, do bear in mind, I am not a master of Tai Chi. I go and see them. And
the whole thing is the laughter and the humour.
Yeah.
I'm sure helps us through.
I think so, because I used to get, when I first started Tai Chi, I used to get really hung up about it and very upset, and it would be another thing I was getting upset about, until I realised if I just enjoy what I'm doing, even if it's completely wrong, just enjoy it, but, you know, try and fix it, obviously, just have a little rest, and then it just, because the most important thing is you're getting this song thing. It's like a relaxed, you're relaxed, but you're also alert. So it's not like slumped in the sofa or falling asleep when you're trying to meditate or something. It's an alert relaxedness, like when you get, when Missy the cat is watching the birds, and you can see her little ears twitching and her, and she's looking very relaxed, but there's any point, and she can pounce, you know, it's that. So that's what we're cultivating, this soft. So if you're practicing being relaxed first and foremost, then the getting the moves right will come with time. You just have to. Okay, so due to popular request, we're going to do some more of the complicated moves. So we're going to start with push away a mountain. Push away. Actually, no, we won't. We'll start with part of the wild horse's mane, which isn't actually a Chen style thing, but because it's got a lot of the silk reading in, and I'll be doing it with Mike, the head honcho, and it's quite nice. So we like this. So you want to be in that leg, rather than leaning. We're avoiding leaning, we're being upright. Upright, that's it. And then we come across, and then we hold the ball, and then we just wind that in, like you're coiling a spring to release the spring. But yeah, I'm enjoying Tai Chi a lot more, even when it's going completely to pot. Because you just go, oh, okay. But yeah, I wish I was in Morocco doing Tai Chi on the beach in the nice warm, you know, 24 degree sunshine. No, I really do.
Mindfulness.
I know. Well, you could all come too, you know.
Imagine I don't.
It's just the airplane, the plane fares are really for the tuition and board. I mean, once you're there, it's fine. You get really good value. But yeah, it's a little bit. It's been beyond my price range for many, many years.
My friends just invited us to Cyprus.
Oh nice.
Yes, but bought a car.
Yeah.
Washing machine.
New
fire. Boiler.
Oh, that's it, you're out. Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah, I mean,
why do they all go at the same time?
I know, it's weird, isn't it?
I suppose you bought them all at the same time, maybe.
Well, when our washing machine goes, there's always people in Cambridge moving out, like professors and that, and then they often put things up on Freecycle.
Right.
So we're going to try for it when it goes. It's still working, but you know.
When it goes.
Well, we got our dryer from Freecycle.
Wow.
We just had to pick it up. It's fantastic. Works, I think. Right? Because it's perfectly working order. They just chuck things and they're not broken.
They can't move them with them.
They can't take them with them if they're going to sort of, you know, back to where they originally came from. Yeah, so.
Yeah. And even if you go into Europe, the electrical charge is different.
Yeah,
that's right. Well,
the plug is different. We're trying to brush away the mountains, so now we've lulled ourselves into metal sensor security. It's strapped down.
Like
so this palm is out and this palm is in, and then you come down, and then long arm, bendy arm. So you turn towards the long arm, then you turn towards the bendy arm, and then you push away the mountain. So this is different. Eva's got a few variations on this one, but this is the one I learned. I can't remember when. And it took me so long to get it, I'm kind of loath to do the new version at the moment. It's slightly, the mechanics are slightly different as well. So, but this will do, it's still a useful thing. So it's confusing, isn't it? So even if you're not doing it how I'm doing it, the fact that we're moving both sides of the body,
you
both
push.
Arms, yeah, you're pushing away the mountain and they do it both sides. So there's a mountain either side of you. Try it out when you need to go, you know, climb up Snowdon or whatever. See if you can push it away. And then, so you're in that leg, then you push.
You push to the opposite leg.
Push to the opposite leg, yeah. In this version. So there are other versions. Now, go into one leg. Both legs. I'm in my left leg. Now I push towards my right leg. Now I sit back. I'm in the right leg. I'm in my left leg. I'm in my right leg. So silk reading is a good thing to do because it helps develop your cognitive function. So even if you're doing a variation of what I'm doing, because you're moving both sides of the body in different ways, you are still exercising your brain, you see. So this is brain exercise. It's why it's hard to do. Is it the corpus callosum? The thing in the middle that bisects the brain, who's clever? And there's like the nerves between, you know, things that work both hemispheres and wake up your corpus callosum. But I could be talking complete nonsense. Look it up on Google. Look up brain hemispheres and corpus callosum and the bit in the middle and how it works.
Or not,
yeah. I think mine's still frozen at the moment. Yeah, it was horrible because I was training, and every time I breathed in, this cold air went. Oh, it was horrible. And then come back. Right, so we'll do middle winding, but we'll give our legs a bit of a rest. So I'll take a look slightly. So the middle winding, this version, one, two, three. Everybody's favourite, because you can feel it. You can feel it. So it's easy. It's like this. We'll see who gets it. It's a bit like rubbing your head and patting your tummy and playing the church organ at the same time, isn't it? It's a bit like that. So. Well, that's good. That's very funny. We're going away for a weekend retreat in the country in Burwell.
It's very ancient.
Yeah, it is. It
is. History is very ancient.
I mean, you've got Wick and Fen,
yes,
which is in Burwell, and that's beautiful. And they've got lovely cats.
Yeah.
My favourite, though, my favourite is Kingfisher's Bridge, is my favourite one at the moment. Because you can get, not that I do, but you can even have cocktails in their cafe. Because it's private, it's not RSPB.
No,
and you can get cakes, cocktails, you can get coffee with Baileys in it. I'm like, goodness me.
Where's this?
Kingfisher's
Bridge.
It's near, yeah.
It's Lytton Road.
Yeah.
Turn off opposite. Oh,
and then it's on the right.
Opposite the turn
it's
to Upware.
Oh, right.
And
yeah,
then you
yeah
follow the track round.
Yeah, you can see the cathedral from the big hill thing. There's a lookout place where you can look at the bison. Is it water buffalo or something? They have water buffalo.
I don't know.
And they have a. It's really beautiful.
Can you walk dogs there?
I
think
yes,
you probably can.
No.
You probably can. Phone them up and ask, because it's always worth asking. They probably want dogs to be on lead, though, because it's a bird reserve. So
they won't want them free running.
They won't want them free running, but I've. Yeah.
Probably a bad idea to miss buffalo anyway. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Cause
well, they've got
that
to
make
it. So that's the other version of middle winding, which... That's a bit easy to understand, because you go flip, flip, and then you have a windy up bit, then flip, flip, and then you do it the other side, flip, windy up a bit, flip, flip, windy up a bit, flip. That's what I called it when I did it. So that's there. And then that's there. So you put your hand on your tummy. Wide, flip, flip, wide. That's it. Yeah. So keep the hand there. So you're not flipping both hands out. You're just doing one at a time. Yeah, yeah. But that wasn't far off. Quite No, I can't remember it. I always mess that one up, so we'll leave that one.
Yeah.
Not middle winding, three circles. I'm going to have some water first, and then I quite like to do white apricot fruit, actually, just because it's... Yeah, there's loads in the kitchen. I've got my firmer's back. So I dropped my old one and it broke. Because even though it was metal, and not, I don't do glass ones anymore, because they don't last 5 seconds with me. Whereas these, you couldn't drop them, but it got dropped so many times, it lost its insulation properties.
I sent my child with them. Elizabeth Day skiing in Scotland.
Yeah.
And the kind of took my heart. My coconut tasted funny.
Oh,
and it all the glasses smelled. Well, yes, it was all right,
very lucky. So,
that's when I changed.
We'll look at three circles and then we'll do my take off as fruit so we can at least move around a bit. And I'm hoping in the break, the Christmas break, I'm taking some time off because I want to go and visit some teachers. I know the guys in Bristol are probably still training, or I might go and see Mark or something and just get a bit of extra training, just to kind of, it's good. I highly recommend doing retreats and things.
I don't know when I'll be back after Christmas. My sister's having an operation.
Okay.
So I'm going up to look after her.
Oh, where does she live?
Yorkshire.
Oh, it's beautiful. Which?
North Yorkshire.
Oh, yes. You have to push over the mountains.
You'll need lots of warm clothes, though.
Yes.
You'll need lots of warm clothes. So,
I've got fleece-lined tights on in a minute.
Yeah.
Yes, you've got no boiler.
So we do this one. So just give it a bash, it's just one, two, so there's turning in the waist, three, four. Really relax, we've got the nice relaxing music, so my friend Nick Penny and his wonderful music. Yeah, I'm hoping, I can maybe... I'm going to be recording some music, hopefully with Nick and hopefully with Peter, because on my personal YouTube channel, I'm going to put my healing music up on there as well as the folk. Basically, the way you get into these is just by doing them over and over and over again until they happen. And then once you get into them, you can start feeling all sorts of interesting things. So you want to relax the shoulders and think about the movement being soft, smooth, and slow. But you've also got this alertness in the body. So yeah, the Tai Chi session at the care home is going brilliantly well with all the people with the dementia, and there's people that haven't got dementia in it as well. It's really fun. Really fun.
Which care home?
Bramley Court. I work there 2 to 3 afternoons a week. Well, I do an evening. I do an afternoon and an evening on a Thursday. That's my long day, so I try and pack them all in on Thursday and then I don't need to come back because I'm on the way. So you're feeling that. You can even do a smaller version. I'll show you the small version. Zoom watching, you can just do that. Simples. Very good. Right, let's go. If we all go, maybe if we all go one end. So we'll just see. You can see how the other half live now. See, I'm not here on my own, just in case those of you.
Well, it's cold on this side, isn't it?
It's cold. It's warming. You should have warmed it up. Really? It's warmer. Oh, look, they've got the radiator.
The bigger one.
That's why.
They have a big one.
Great and big one. Why haven't they got a radiator on that?
Well, they can't see.
They should have one on each. Anyway,
we've got the
three radiators. Waist moving, and then we'll do bounce. Oh, that's so nice. And shake. So, Freya and Estelle's nieces used to, if they were, when they were three or four, and they knew there was going to be cake, they'd go. cake. So think that when you do it. So much better, everybody.
Thank you.
remembered. Thanks very much.
Finished putting my pocket.
Brilliant, thank you. Till the 20th of December is the last one. Then we restart on the 10th of, or is it the 11th? Something like that, of January.
Thank you. Bye.